Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay, and the beer we're going to do at the moment, the beer I'm going to do, see I'm getting very posh, very salubrious. I'm going to do, I feel like celebrating today, so I'm going to do Stout Port Stout. Now I've seen with these that they've, that, you know, the Stouter Stout, so the Stouter Port Stout. Not only is it stout, but it's stouter. You know, I've gone over all that stout, what the meaning of it is. In the Durham Brewery's white stout. Go and have a look, find it. Now we've got one of these tops with a cage, which probably means it's fizzy in there, so I'm going to have to be a bit quick and a bit careful, so I've got my glass ready. Now, port stout. See, we've had stout. I've seen that one about, or a boat, a stout, stouter stout, as they say in Canada. Sorry, guys. Of course, got a bit of sticky stuff to this one. Marble Brewery Stout Port Stouter Port Stout. Now, Port Stout. I want a bit of help on this one because, as far as I know, there's two conflicting, not so much conflicting, because there's some belief both ways of was doing it, that it was either stout that was kind of put in a port cask, that could work, or a stout that in a fermenter. They just poured a couple of two or three bottles or whatever, depending on the size of the fermenter, obviously, of port in there with it. So, you guys let me know, if anyone does know out there, if it's just conjecture, if you're just kind of not sure, you know, give us your opinion. But if you know, or if you kind of have got a bloody good idea of it, let me know in the comments down here. Let me know. Cool, this is kind of a. They've got a tight little turny ring there. I ain't left a bit much of a loop. I'm having to turn it like that with me fingertips. And it's not nice. Ouch. Let's dunk my fingers, look. Soft hands, isn't it? There you go. Oof, hold on. Ouch! What are you tighten this up with? Pliers or something? Ouch! Ouch! I thought I was tough. Right, there we go. Finally got it off. Broke my fingers. Put dents galore in my thumbs and everything else. Right, carefully get it. Turn the bottle. Hold that bit of your finger. Hold that bit together. And then get the rest of it, turn the bottle over, so you've got something over the top. And hopefully it should come up, but it's not gonna, it's not even turning. So if it don't turn, get your something over the top and shift it with your thumb like that, backwards and forwards. But here it goes, it should hopefully go, probably go all over my trousers leg, but it should go. Ready? There you go. Hold the top on, and you'll see carbon dioxide. Oh, pause. There you go. Isn't it lovely, isn't it? Right. Christ. God, that's massive. That is massive. That smells chocolatey, coffee, bouncing, all sorts of cherries, kind of currants, raisins. Oh, wow. Well, I'm going to just put a bit more in. Wait a minute. Oh, wowza. Oh, have a look. lovely big frothy head on it. It's not kind of clinging much to the edge there, but so it'll probably dissipate quite quickly. I don't know if we, no, you won't be able to see nothing of the carbonation there. But it's making its way, it's dissipating, now it's starting to cling to the edge a little bit. But it's kind of flopping down quite quickly, which is all good. Kind of helps to denote how the mouth feels going to be. But, oh man, you're getting Granny's marmalade. You're getting that lovely, thick cut, well-cooked up marmalade. Boiling up there. It's just, if you go like that and then just turn your nose away a little bit, you're getting a little bit of strawberry notes in there. Just as you draw your nose out of the drink, it kind of, as if you've grabbed the strawberry and it's trying, finally got up there. Just as you go outside of it and you've got some up your bugle already. In here, you don't get it because you've got them currants and caramel in there have overtaken it. As you get away from them, it finally erupts. Oh, wow. That is lovely. Little bit of a kind of slight vanilla-y edge. You are getting a kind of sherry port sort of, I think more sherry sort of casks idea. Kind of, you've got a little woody, dry woody notes, as if you've burnt the inside of the barrel, and you've got that kind of ashy sort of burnt inside a wooden barrel smell. You know, when you open the top of the wooden barrel and you get all them things coming out of the little hole in that there. When it's been burnt off. I don't know what they call that. But now I'm getting the port. As it sits and warms for a while and opens up, so then you're getting the port notes coming in. Sweet sherry notes as well, but there's port notes in there as well. Oh, I'm going in almost a rum as well in there. Kind of that rum and raisin chocolate. Rum and raisin chocolates, all the lots in here. I'm going in. Cheers. I maybe sometime. Oh, wow. That is so complex, so lovely. I love when a beer does that, when it just hits you on all sorts of angles of attack. You've got a lovely, bitter, dark, bitter finish. Kind of toasted coffee, burnt toast. That sort of lovely, hefty ristretto coffee. That strong, that sort of almost like, if you ever had like Turkish coffee in that, you know, you sometimes, it's very sweet, but you get that coating of powdery sort of coffee on your tongue after sometimes. And once the sweetness goes and kind of melts and you swallow, you end up with that stuck on your tongue a little bit. And it's a lovely, beautiful bitterness. It's a lovely coffee-edged bitterness. I would swear that there was robust coffee in that. But of course, that's lovely. Let's go down with a bit more. That is so lovely. That really is lovely. That is so beautifully brewed. You got kind of a medium line on the finish. You've got like after a long while down the finish and all the way through the finish, you've got a bit of coffee. You got halfway along the finish, right from the start to halfway along, you got a porty sort of rummy sort of note in there and stuck to the tongue. And then when that disappears, then the coffee comes in and goes, coming in, finish off, right, we're leaving the restaurant, come and have your coffee, hurry up, that sort of thing, you know. Oh, wow. And the first thing that comes in, You've got the lot in there, but you get a zing off of orange zest and a kind of See, people hate when I say this, but bergamot orange, that kind of that Earl Grey sort of tea. It's like an Earl Grey tea, like a bergamot orange, little bit of tea, little bit of bergamot orange, a little bit of a zest, all coming, kind of punching in there with a little bit of one of those red grapefruits as well. Mmm. Oh, that is lovely. That is spectacular. Getting bread notes as well. Little edges of hot cross bun in there. But it's not cloyingly sweet or nothing. It's got a sweet edge and it's got a bitter kind of grasping thing that's just sands all that way. So there's a sweet edge and a lovely dark, dark bitterness. And there's that big lush chocolate. Very high kind of... I was going to say a high gravity chocolate, but a high, it's kind of is, but a high cocoa chocolate. And that is really, really glorious. Well, I've got to say, absolutely no doubt, try it, buy it, love it. That is lovely. Marble from Manchester. Whoa. Marble from Manchester, that is 5.1 ABV, and it is bloody lovely. Cheers, bottoms up, and chin chin up your bottoms.